Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the process to change out our input shaft seals on our 40 horsepower, 4-stroke Mercury outboard. Now, as you can see, we've already got the two separated. Now, if you need help doing that, check out this unit's playlist and I can walk you through the process. It's really pretty easy. But now that they're separated, let's step over to the parts table, look at the parts that I chose to pull this off, and then we'll dive into it. What I decided to do here was, instead of just ordering the specific parts that we're going to do on this particular project, I went ahead and ordered a seal kit that has everything that you would need, no matter which part of your lower unit is leaking. So now that we've got our parts together, let's go over there and knock it out. Now, it's important before you get started on this, guys, to go ahead and drain it. Otherwise, you're going to make a big mess on your floor. So go ahead and get that out of the way now. Let's go ahead and get our prop off. I don't know what the torque value is off the top of my head, but I'm betting that wasn't enough. That came off, but not by much. That's why it's important to grease these when you put them together. Get these two bolts, 13 millimeters. We're going to need a puller to get this section out, and you could use a slide hammer. I'm actually using a Yamaha one, just whatever you have access to, just to get a little bit of tension to where we can pop this housing out. Like I said, I think this outboard's been sitting up for a while. All right, let's go ahead and get this out. Let's tilt that down a little bit so we don't get all that trash up in the front housing. There we go. Next, we need to get the pinion nut off, and this isn't a real high torque situation, so we're just going to grab the input shaft with a cloth and a pair of vice grips in a non-essential area, and then that should be enough to hold it still to pop it loose. So with the pinion nut off, what we should be able to do next is just grab it and pull it through. But I can tell you by looking at this carrier, it's got a fair amount of corrosion. So we're going to need to leave our vice grips in place and use a hammer to go ahead and knock it up. There we go. Yeah, a fair amount of corrosion around there. Not horrible, but enough to hold it back. Let's get this pulled apart, cleaned up, and then we'll start replacing seals and get it put back together. So here's what we've got inside this little carrier housing. You've got a neoprene seal up top, what they call a metal seal down below, and then we have an O-ring, believe it or not, that has been encrusted on the outside of it. So what we're gonna do is pull this off the shaft, remove that O-ring, and then go in and pry out the seals and drive in the new ones. When I've had the vice grips up top to knock this thing out, it actually scarred up the shaft itself. So guess what? When we go to put these seals back on, it's probably going to cut into them. What I need to do is grind this back, get off the sharp edges, and maybe use an emery cloth on it so we can reuse it. Let's start off by getting the carrier out of the way. And I'm actually going to take this over to a vise, get it held in place, and I'm going to straighten up where I've scarred the shaft itself. At that point, we'll come back, get these old seals out, and get the new ones pressed in. Yeah, much better. Now that we've got the drive shaft straightened out, let's go ahead and start working on the seal carrier. The way we're gonna do this, just use a couple of different sockets. Gonna use this one as a cup to drive into, and then a 19 millimeter up top to push them out. Now we got them. Now I'm going to carry this over to the parts washer, get all this corrosion and crap scrubbed off of it. Then we can start putting it back together. Next thing we need to do is drive in our seal. We're going to start with the metal one first. We're going to put some thread locker around the outside and then drive it in. Now the book says that we need to use a press, but not everybody has a press at their house. So I'm just going to give you a workaround. Doesn't take much, just a light bead all the way around. We'll get it started. Make sure she's going in square. So what I'm going to do is actually use an impact socket to drive it in, just bottoming it out. Next, we're going to take the neoprene seal, and it actually faces out. You don't need to put any Loctite on it, and just press it in until she bottoms. This one doesn't take nearly as much effort as the metal one. Yep, they're bottomed out. So we're good to go. Get on our O-ring. What we're gonna do now is put a layer of grease around the O-ring, and then we're gonna pack grease on the inside in between the two seals. We wanna go ahead and put a couple of wraps of electrical tape over the section where I use the vice grips on it. It just has to be one layer. You just want something in between it and those new seals. Here we go. Piece of cake. All right, guys, before we put that together, I'm looking at the actual housing, because remember, it took a fair amount to get the input shaft to come out, and there's still some corrosion that's kind of embedded. What I'm going to use is a Dremel with a very fine wire brush and lightly go through it, because what you don't want to happen is to actually cut into the housing itself. This is actually in good shape, so we're just going to reinstall it. What we're going to do, though, is let gravity help us a little bit while we're doing this. There she goes. Now the other tricky part is to get your other bearing to stay up inside the race. We're going to take a little bit of grease. Don't get carried away with it. And this should help to hold it into that outer race. Get your pinion gear ready. Now we can bring in the input shaft. There she is. Let's go ahead and get the nut started. Then we'll drive that upper seal housing in, and then get the pinion nut tightened down. All right, so it's holding it in place. Now we can bring everything vertical, finish driving that housing down, and tighten up that pinion nut. So we've got all our gears in place, and we're getting ready to put the pinion nut on, but you want to go ahead and put some Loctite on the threads, and then we're going to put 50 foot-pounds on it. Where you see that little edge, see how it's kind of raised? That's the part that has to go up. There she goes. Since I'm not using the holder for the splines up top, we're going to go back to our vice grips, and then we'll actually have a torque wrench down here. And hopefully I can get that tight enough to get that 50 foot-pounds on. So let's see if we can get this thing to clamp down hard enough to hold everybody still. Coming up. There you go. All right, guys, that's pretty much gonna wrap up the input seals. Now I still have to put together the output seals with the carrier as well as the water pump. So we're gonna kind of fast forward through that. But if you need help doing it, we actually have separate videos that can walk you through the exact process. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Hey, you like what you see? Why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you'll be notified and you can see whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.